Hello everyone! If you're new to the channel, you might think the title of this video is absolute nonsense clickbait, but I assure you, it's not. I'm actually going to be sending out free computer hardware, so listen up. If you like old school retro computers and gadgets and like playing with electronics, but thought it's an expensive hobby, I can promise you that it doesn't have to be. About a year ago, I started making this. It's an 8-bit 6502 computer, not unlike the Atari 2600, the old Commodores, Apple 1 and 2, the NES, and so many others. But for mine, I decided it would be fun to make it into a single breadboard computer, and that worked out great. And it was a lot of fun, but it wasn't very practical. And that's why I made it into a different kind of single board computer with its own PCB and everything. It even has a socket for a little OLED screen, and it's pretty easy to turn it into an old school handheld gaming device. And you can bet I'll be making games like Flappy Bird for it. But maybe most interesting of all, it's one of the easiest ways ever to get your hands on a real 6502 computer. I designed it as an electronics development board, so it's easy to hook up to a breadboard and use with a bunch of add-ons made for other boards, and that's why I decided to call it the 6502ino. From the beginning, it's been completely open source, both the hardware and software, so anyone can make their own and send the board design off to a manufacturer and have it made. You won't believe how excited I am to give a bunch of these boards away for absolutely free. And that brings us to the sponsor of this video, jlcpcb.com. I've used jlcpcb for years and they've always been super helpful and delivered super fast, so when they asked to collaborate on a project like this, I wasn't very hard to convince. If you're new to electronics and haven't heard of jlcpcb before, they're a major PCB manufacturer, but they also do assembly, 3D printing, CNC machining, and industrial parts. Ordering printed circuit boards is as simple as uploading a zip file with the Gerber files from something like KiCad, like the one in my GitHub repo, and selecting the features you want, like color, surface finish, and board thickness. The defaults are usually fine, and ordering. You can also have boards manufactured directly, so you don't need to do any soldering. And all that takes is to upload the BOM and placement files, so that's what I did. Creating those in KiCad turned out to be pretty easy, but if you're making somebody else's design, like mine for instance, chances are the files will already be available. I like to do a few manual checks to make sure everything looks fine, but the times I've missed something, JLCPCB's engineering team have actually caught it and given me a chance to fix it before production. I really appreciate that. If you sign up to JLCPCB and sign up using the link in the description, you not only get 5 PCBs for as little as $2, you also get 54 bucks worth of coupons. When ordering PCBs, express shipping usually takes about 7 days to my location, and this time I received the package in 10 days, even though I also asked to have the boards manufactured with all the SMD parts. And that's how I got this. I ordered as many 6502ino PCBs with the SMD components pre-soldered as JLCPCB would let me, as part of the sponsorship. And that turned out to be quite a lot, so I really hope I didn't mess up my order or the last redesign. I don't remember the last time I was this excited to open a package of boards. I haven't changed the revision number, but maybe I should have, since I actually did add a SOT23 inverter as an alternative footprint of the DIP14, since we only need a single gate for address decoding when we use an SMD oscillator instead of the inverter crystal oscillator circuit. Here we go. It looks like the top panel is an extra blank one I also ordered. Sometimes it's nice to have a blank PCB for experiments or a physical record of where a trace was on a specific board. I have a bit of reflection going on, so it's a bit hard to see, but these are gorgeous. The gold plating always looks good, but for these boards I chose the nickel gold pads because I don't know how long I'll be storing them and it doesn't oxidize the same way over time the tin solder pads do. I also put the pinout on the back of the PCB so you don't have to look at the documentation to figure out where a wire goes. But this panel is just extra. I'm not even going to give these away because underneath we should have the real deal, the boards with all the SMD components pre-soldered that I am going to be giving away. I'm sorry about the camera glare, but in real life they look absolutely perfect. Or at the very least as good as I designed them. Before I solder the sockets and pin headers to the board, I'd like to confirm I didn't mess up anything horribly. I don't even have to depanelize a board to connect since the USB power connector is on the right side here. Moment of truth. There we go. There's a white LED and a faint red LED. I absolutely hate it when I get blinded by a power indicator light in a dark room, so I went low with the LED current. Like, really low. These are the LEDs on the power rails. They're the most basic LEDs JLC PCB could find, and they light up enough to tell me the rails are fine, with limiting resistors making the current through them just 220 microamps. So remember that. When the datasheet says 20 milliamps is 100% brightness, you can actually go 100 times lower and still get what you want. The USB cable is connected through a USB hub with some power draw and another long cable, so I guess 4.8 volts makes sense. And the 3.3 volt regulator does a reasonable job regulating. Right now, it's just supplying power to the red LED and the 1 MHz oscillator. And speaking of, let's check if that works too. .999 kHz looks good. Especially considering my meter also picks up my local AC frequency as 49.99 Hz. So, I blame the meter instead of the oscillator. I actually thought I was out of spec feeding the 5-volt CPU a 3-volt peak-to-peak input clock from the oscillator, but it turns out that according to the datasheet for both the Rockwell and UMC6502s, 5-0 only needs to swing above 2.4 volts, which means it's well within spec as long as VCC is around 5 volts. Well, nothing's shorted and the oscillator's running. I guess it's time to depanelize a board and do a little bit of easy soldering. Please don't consider this a soldering tutorial, since I'm probably not going to win the Hackaday soldering challenge anytime soon, but let it be a demonstration of how easy it is to solder a 65Oino. I'm timing this, but I'm not really in a hurry. If you haven't ordered assembled boards before, you might wonder why I didn't just have JLC PCB solder the easy-to-solder sockets and pin headers too. It just comes down to automation. All the SMD components can easily be placed by pick-and-place machines and soldered without human intervention. The through-hole components, on the other hand, usually need to be placed by hand and either soldered using an old-school process called wave soldering or by hand, like I'm doing here. That means the price goes up a lot if I wanted the through-hole components soldered too. But this way, they're cheap enough to give away. At least a few of them. So while I finish soldering this, I might as well get the cat out of the bag and clarify what exactly it is I'm giving away and how you can get it. I'm giving away 25 of the boards as I received them from JLC PCB, including regulators, the oscillator, the inverter, USB connector, LEDs and passives, but I'm not giving away sockets, pin headers, or the three main ICs, the 6507, 6532, and ROM. After all, the idea behind the whole project is to reuse and recycle as many used parts as possible. I have a few used parts you can buy, but I do expect most people who are interested in a free board like this might already have things like the DIP28 sockets, the ROMs, and 6507s. Oh, and then there's shipping. I have no way of knowing where you live, but for the first 5 people who want one of these, I will pay for shipping too out of my own pocket. More on that in a second. The rest of the boards I'll have to charge for a traceable small packet, but luckily I got a deal with the local post so I can ship to 52 countries. Cheaper than I can ship a packet domestically. Go figure. Until a few years ago, I had a store with a web shop doing smartphone repairs and selling accessories, but that's been dormant since I got my new day job. But for this, I gave it a brush up, made sure it works in English, and revived it so I can use it to send out these boards. If you're quick enough, you can use the coupon in the video description to get free global shipping, meaning you won't have to pay a single cent to get a free 8-bit 65Oino motherboard delivered to your door. If the coupon doesn't work, you can assume 5 other people already got the free shipping, since it'll only work 5 times total. But I hope the shipping cost won't keep too many people away from a free 65Oino board. As an example, sending from Europe to New Zealand is only 5 euros 27 cents. If the coupon does work, because you're one of the first 5 to use it, I hope you'll be kind enough to leave a comment here on YouTube expressing your excitement that you didn't have to use your credit card at all. The link to order your free 65Oino motherboard is in the description along with the early bird free shipping coupon code. This might seem like a lot of work, packaging, shipping, and accounting just to give away something, actually at a loss. But since I got them for free from JLC PCB, I don't mind spending a bit of my free time to pass along some of the fun. In return, I hope some of you will try it out and give me some feedback and maybe write some games and apps for it, for the good of all of us. It looks like I didn't mess anything up with my soldering and I can get back to coding Flappy Bird like I keep mentioning. I took my time with the soldering here, and even under the camera, it only took about 14 minutes. I can't wait to hear how fast you can do it, so please put that in a comment and join the growing community on Discord. Thanks to JLC PCB for sponsoring the project, and I hope this will turn out to be a fun experiment for everyone involved. Either way, thanks for watching.